insane.
Look at this island bench, said Shona.
This is a catwalk.
It is. If I had to sort of describe what is the perfect kitchen for now, for 2020, it would look something like this. It's got that sort of Scandi utilitarian, that sense of functionality, but it's got all the touch points of luxury as well.
Into the butler's pantry.
Just like a little service area, because that kitchen is so big.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't have to be a massive butler's pantry.
But it does its job. This is exactly what a butler's pantry is for.
And it's just right.
Glass shelves are lovely too. I love these. I like the combination of the black frame with the glass shelves.
Yeah.
Darren walked in and quite literally hugged the end of your island bench.
Wow.
Ooh, that's real stone.
That is a monolith.
It's a great-looking kitchen, but not faultless. He thinks the decision to add the drawer under the ovens has pushed the overhead cupboards up too high.
If you took these drawers away, those would come down.
Shona couldn't reach for a glass in the lower part of the cupboards.
I could only get what's in the front of any of these cupboards. I could not even get what's at the back.
Into the butler's pantry, and Shona couldn't wait to play with the louvers.
Oh, can I please let me do it? Because I've only seen them in the showroom and never in anyone's home.
Oh.
Look at that.
Whoa.
Can you have two monoliths in one day?
If Hero Island benches are a thing, then you certainly delivered one too. And then some.
God, that is beyond a work of art. Look at the curve here. Then it comes around, opens up. It curves under there. It's stunning. Boom, we have the ovens. This is sensational.
You've got a warming drawer, oven. Is that the microwave too?
Yes.
Yeah.
It's like there's a whole other kitchen.
I think it's really nice that they've broken up the ovens here and the ovens there so that you can actually do two sets of cooking.
This has gone way beyond just butler's pantry. This is a butler's kitchen. Watermelon sugar
high. You beat me to it.
As Darren walked in from the hallway, his hand reached out and said,
it's all about this corrugated, curved finish today, isn't it?
Which really connects to what they did in the bathroom at the front too.
You were going for that, weren't you?
Yeah.
Before the fluted glass showers.
Glass and yeah.
Into the butler's pantry, and they found pull-out pantry, pull-out saucepan shelves, and another dishwasher.
More magic.
All right, finally a pull-out pantry.
That's great.
Not sure how I feel about these open shelves with the baskets in. Jars, for me, it doesn't gel with the incredibly sleek aesthetic on the other side of that wall.
Look at that for a surprise.
And what did they find in there? Gaggenau.
It's clear who won the Gaggenau Prize.
Wow.
Yep.
How incredible is that?
It's certainly a value add, that's for damn sure.
Darren was amazed at the colour palette.
Mint green and Gaggenau and brass and oak and grey. It shouldn't work, but it all does.
Once again, Neil wasn't loving the open shelving.
But I have to say the mint green is kind of saving it because it's becoming like a cute detail.
And then into the main event.
Keep it going, yeah.
Yeah. I kind of feel like I'm holding you guys.
Let's open the present.
All right. Jeez.
Oh, that terrazzo is gorgeous.
This is the first time we've seen gas as well today.
Yes.
The whole day. Everything else has been induction.
And Gaggenau, once again, a wonderful inclusion.
This is amazing. Look at over there. We have that wine fridge. We have a freezer, I think. Please don't tell me that is a fridge. Oh, my God. Wow. So it's touch. Look at the size of that. I mean, the trays you can fit in there. That is insane.
It's kooky. I mean, this is a kooky kitchen. This is not anything that you see in a catalogue and go, yeah, I'll have that, thanks.
But maybe you will now. Mmm. Neil thinks it's so of the era, it just speaks to the 1950s, but also spot on for 2020. The winner is...